Motor steering is a classic simulator that everybody should be going through. The motor starting simulator asks the user to start very big motors at the end of very long lines, while keeping the frequency and the voltage within very close limits at several locations. The simulator checks the user's actions. If this is not done correctly, the simulator will trip and bring the user to a halt. The users will have to start over again. Let's describe what we are looking at. On the bottom left, the black start units. From them the users can control the frequency and the voltage. Then a 138 kV line. At the end of the line there is a big substations with transformers 138 kV to 240 kV. At the substation, there is a global load tap changer command to control also the voltage. On top of the substation there are three long 240 kV lines, going to three big coal power plants. Each one of these lines has different length and also different Faraday effect. All lines, motors, generators are controlled by breakers. At the end of the three lines, there are three big coal power plants. Voltage is brought down to 4 kV by auxiliary transformers, not equipped with load tap changers. On the 4 kV buses, there are several emergency motors that have to be started very quickly. In the power plants, we can see the motors. On the left, the size of the motors in horsepower. In the middle, the breakers for the motors, with the motors number. On right, this will be the load of the motors, in MVA, after starting them. On top of the power plants, in the blue square, there will be the actual voltage metering. Always remember, the voltage buses is at 4 kV. On top of the blue square and the white square, this is the percentage of the actual voltage divided by the 4000 volts basis voltage. In the orange square is the frequency metering. Let's give it a trial. If we click on the black start unit, we can see that the frequency went up at 60 Hz. And then we energize the 138 kV line closing its breaker. Already the Faraday effect is there. Voltage increases at 139 kV at the end of the line. Now let's energize the 240 kV. We can see that the voltage at the beginning of the line is at 237 kV and at the end at 242 kV. The voltage on the 4 kV bus is at 4188 volts. And the percentage actual voltage over the basis voltage is at 100.7%. We know that when we will start one of these big motors, the load could be at least 6 and up to 10 times the normal full load of the motor. So let's pre-adjust the voltage before starting the motor. Changing the load tap changer at the big substation will increase the voltage on the 240 kV line and on the 4 kV bus. Voltage at the end of the 240 kV line is now at 262 kV. Voltage on the 4 kV bus is at 4534 volts. The percentage is at 109%. Let's see what will happen instantaneously. And on rolling time, with the load of the motor, the voltage, and that the frequency. Voltage went down, on the 4 kV bus, to 3143 volts. The voltage percentage went down to 75.6%. The frequency went down to 59.068 Hz. Do not forget that the grid impedance of the grid system is very large. There is only one big unit in service. And lines, transformers, in series. As you can see, after very few seconds, after the motor accelerate, the voltage and the frequency are going up. The users will be able to experience the very dynamic effect of the simulator. Like in real time. And a few seconds later, you can see that the motor is now at full speed. Voltage percentage is up to 104.8%. The frequency is still low, because the user did not pre-adjust the frequency before starting the motor. Let's start another motor. This time, we will pre-adjust the frequency and the voltage. Before starting the motor, this is always what the operators should do in real time. Communications between the balancing operator, the power plant operator, and the black start unit operator. to ensure everybody will expect what will happen and not overreact in real time. This time the motor loading went up to 32 MVA, the voltage percentage went down to 88%, and the frequency to 59.592 Hz. The users, like in real time, can start the same motor 100 times. He will never have the same effect. This is due to the residual magnetic field remaining in the motor. Sometimes this will be helping. Sometimes not. Be prepared for everything. The users will have to start all the motors in the three power plants, respecting the frequency and proper voltage all the time and at every locations. If not, the user will have to start over. We hope you enjoyed this presentation. There are several levels with this category, from beginners to experts to ultra operators. In which category do you belong to?